In this video, we are going to talk about discrete random variable. What is a discrete random variable? A real valued function defined on a discrete sample space is called a discrete random variable. Let's understand this with the help of an example. So let's say our x is the AC temperature of a room. So usually the AC temperature ranges from 16 to 30. In this case, our sample space would be 16 to 17 to 30. So the possible values that our x can take is basically 16, 17 till 30. And this is our sample space. Since these are countable, this means that it is a discrete sample space. Hence, a discrete random variable. Now, let's move on to some of the examples that we have. So a random variable x has the following probability function. Values of x are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and the following probabilities. Now find k. Now we already know that there are two properties that satisfy probability function. That is that summation of px should be equal to 1 and that px should be greater than 0 for every x. Now, considering the first property, that summation of px is equal to 1, we have k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k plus k square plus 2k square plus 7k square plus k equal to 1. This means that 10k square plus 9k is equal to 1, which implies that 10k square plus 9k minus 1 equal to 0. So if you see over here, this is A, this is C, then the multiplication of these two is equal to 10. Now we have to find two possible numbers such that their summation is 9 and the multiplication is 10. So that would be 10 minus 1. That is, now we have 10k k plus 1 minus 1, k plus 1 is equal to 0, 10k minus 1 into k plus 1 equal to 0. Now this implies that our k is equal to 1 by 10 or minus 1. According to the second property of probability function is that every probability should be greater than 0. So this rules out the possibility that k is equal to minus 1, since the probability of when x is equal to 1 is equal to k, hence it cannot be minus 1. So the answer is k is equal to 1 by 10. Let's move on to the second part of the question, that is finding probability x less than 6, probability x greater than equal to 6 and probability x lying between 0 and 5. For probability x less than 6, we have k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k plus k square. We are taking the probability still here, since probability x less than 6, that is probability x is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 8k plus k square, which is equal to 8 by 10 plus 1 by 100, which is equal to 81 by 100. Let's move on to the second part of the question, which is probability x greater than equal to 6. Now this is actually the probability that probability x is less than 6, which is equal to 1 minus 81 by 100, 19 by 100. Now let's move on to the third part, that is probability 0 till 5. Okay, in this case we have probability x is equal to 1 plus 2 3 4. So this is equal to k plus 2k plus 2k plus 2k plus 3k, which is equal to which is equal to k, 3k, 5k, 8k, 8 by 10. Hence, this is the answer. Now, determining the distribution function of x. which is basically probability x less than or equal to x for different for different values of x. In this case, what we have that probability if 0, when x is less than or equal to 0, then for probability x less than or equal to 1, we have 0 plus 1 by 10, which is equal to 1 by 10. X less than or equal to 2 is 1 by 10, that is this, plus probability x is equal to 2, which is equal to 2 by 10, plus 1 by 10, which is equal to 3 by 10. Probability x less than or equal to 3 is equal to 3 by 10, plus probability x is equal to 3, which is equal to 2 by 10, that is half. Then x less than or equal to 4, we have half plus probability that x is equal to 4, which is 3 by 10. So we have 8 by 10. For x less than or equal to 5, we have 8 by 10 plus probability x is equal to 5, which is 1 by 100. That means 81 by 100. For x less than or equal to 6, we have 81 by 100 plus probability x is equal to 6, which is equal to 2 by 100. So 83 by 100. And for x less than or equal to 7, we have 7 by 100 plus 1 by 10 plus 83 by 100, which is equal to 1. So this completes our distribution function of x. Let's move on to our second example, where we have px is equals to x by 15 for x is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 0 elsewhere. So the first question is finding probability x is equals to 1 or 2. In this case, what is this? Then probability x is equal to 1 plus probability x is equal to 2, which is equal to 1 by 15 plus 2 by 15, which is equal to 3 by 15, which is equal to 1 by 5. Let's move on to our second question. That is probability that x lies between half and 5 by 2, given that x is equal to 1. So this, according to our conditional probability, this is equal to half and intersection of x greater than 1 upon probability x greater than 1. So since probability A given B is equals to probability A intersection B upon probability of B, this is the conditional probability. So when does this particular thing happen for x? So this particular thing happens for x is equals to 1 or x is equals to 2, and then we have intersection x greater than 1 upon probability x greater than 1. So the intersection of these two is basically nothing but probability x is equals to 2, and probability x greater than 1 is nothing but probability x less than or equal to 1, which is equal to 2 by 15, since probability of x is equals to 2 is 2 by 15, then 1 minus probability x less than or equal to 1 is basically 1 minus probability x is equals to 1, which is equal to 2 by 15 upon 1 minus 1 by 15, which is equal to 2 by 15 upon 14 by 15, which is equal to 2 by 14, which is equals to 1 by 7. This is our answer. With this, we come to the end of our video. Thank you.